Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, this is Mr. Cervone. So today in lesson 93, we will be learning about volume and surface area and how to find these. For the do now, it says find the volume and surface area of the hollow concrete block shown in the figure below, given that x is equal to 3 inches. I'm sure many of you have seen these concrete blocks that are hollow. Specifically, when building a wall in construction where rebars go inside this way. As a matter of fact, let me just draw it in really quick. Okay, there you go, like this. So you have these rebars inside like this. And then what happens is that concrete is being poured in this hollows of the concrete blocks. So that you can make a wall. So it's actually important to know what the volume and surface area is for the design process and to establish the cost of such construction materials. Okay, so without further ado, let's find the volume. So for the volume, we can just simply write 3x times 8x times 2x, which will give us the volume of the entire concrete block without the empty spaces inside. But if we want to subtract the empty spaces inside, we just do 2 times 2x times x times 3x. Why is it times 2 over here? Well, because we have 2 empty spaces, or the hollows in this case. Well, if you do the math, you end up with 48x cubed minus 12x cubed, which is going to give us a volume of 36x cubed. Now, if we substitute 3 for x, the volume will be 36 times 3 cubed, which is equal to 36 times 27. And the final answer is just going to be 972. Keep in mind that volume has a unit of cubed units. So in this case, I'm going to write unit cubed, and that is the volume. Actually, in this case, we have inches. So we're going to write inches cubed, and that is the unit, okay? So basically, if the unit is not given, you should always write unit cubes. Okay, so this was the first part. For the second part, we want to find the surface area. So the surface area is a little bit more involved. Now we have to think about, okay, let's say if we had to spray paint the entire concrete block. What are all the surfaces outside and also inside? Okay, so we kind of have to now organize this entire problem to find the surface area. For example, we can just look at the front and the back, the top and the bottom, the left and the right piece, and then the inside piece. So let's organize this as follows. So the outside part consists of the front part, which is just 3x times 8x equal to 24x squared. Then the back part, which is also the same, 24x squared. Now the left part consists of 3x, which is the height of the block, times 2x, which is the depth. So the left and the right part are the same, which are 6x squared. Okay, so now the bottom part without the hollow part is 8x. Times 2x equal to 16x squared, okay? And then we also have a top part of 8x times 2x equal to 16x squared, so they're basically the same. And again, this is imagining as if there's no hollow part at all. Now we want to subtract the hollow part, okay, from the top and the bottom. So if you look closely for the top part over here, so maybe I should highlight this. There you go, this one. This is just x times 2x, okay? And there are two of them. 1 and 2. So that's why we subtract all of this. Okay. And the same goes for the bottom. So we're going to subtract the same amount on the bottom. Okay. Okay. So this was the outside part. What about the inside part? What is the surface area if you look inside the hollow part? Okay. So the inside part consists of the following. So here we have the empty put over here. Okay, so the inside part, there's a front part, which is just the 2x here, so all of this. So actually, let me draw it three as if it's like inside. So this is the front part, which is 2x, okay, from here to here, and the height over here is 3x, okay. So that's why we multiply 2x times 3x over here, but we have two of those, and that's where the 2 comes from over here, this 2. Okay, so then we have a back part, which is exactly the same. So the shape is identical, so it's also 12x squared. So then we have the left part over here. So if you would look inside, it would actually look like this, okay? That would be the left part of it. And obviously we have two of these. And again, the depth is 2x and the height is 3x. And that's the reason why we multiply x times 3x, but then we multiply by 2 because we have two of these. Okay, so now for the right part, it's the same exact thing. Now we have this piece over here and this piece over here, if you can imagine it in three dimensions. And that is basically the same as the left part, so you end up with 6x squared, okay? All right, so now that we have the outside part and the inside part, what do we do here? We just simply add them up. Okay, so if you add these up, you get the following. So the total surface area is 92x squared, and the 92x squared comes from here. That is 92x squared, okay? Then we're going to subtract the minus, or subtract 8x squared. And this is the part here. That's minus 8x squared. Okay. And then we have this part over here, which is 36x squared that we're adding. So if you add everything up, if you do 92x squared minus 8x squared plus 36x squared, you end up with 120x squared. So the only thing remaining is to substitute x equal to 3, and then you end up with 1080 units squared. Okay, now since 3 is in inches, we can also write that the total surface area is equal to 1080 inches squared. Okay, and that is the answer. So let's quickly define volume and surface area. So the volume is defined as the quantity of three-dimensional space enclosed by some closed boundary. So basically, to find the volume, you just take the product of the length, width, and height of a figure. And keep in mind that here, in this lesson, we're only considering volumes and surface areas of rectangular figures or rectangular prisms of that sort, none of which have rounded surfaces or lateral surface areas, okay? So these are just definitions that are applicable for rectangular prisms. So the total surface area is defined as follows. The surface area of a solid object is the total area of the object's faces and curved surfaces. So this total surface area applies also for curved surfaces, but again, keep in mind that in this lesson we're only concerned with rectangular figures. In the next upcoming videos that I will be posting, we will be looking at other shapes, how to find the volume and surface areas, for example, of cones, spheres, cylinders, pyramids, and other prisms. Okay, so that's basically it for today's lesson. So what I would like you to do is to please check Schoology or Scheduler or PupilPath, and please complete homework 93. You will see a worksheet there. Please complete it and submit your completed assignment with all the work shown through Schoology. Other than that, thank you for watching and have a great day.